So welcome back to another video with Grant's Heating and Air. Today we're going to talk about a system we did for a customer where we were able to take two furnaces and move them into one furnace and take care of the entire home. So let's get right into it. We're going to actually show some pictures and show where they were before and the two furnaces they had before. One furnace, as you'll see in the photos, was tucked back in this corner. Another furnace was right in this location somewhere. And what they were doing with the original furnaces were they were using, you can see three trunk lines here. You've got a supply, and this one is for the main floor. You got a return, which both furnaces were sharing. And then you have one right here, which was for the upstairs. And so we had one furnace connected here, one connected here, and they were both sharing that return. So some of the problems going into the new equipment with this kind of setup is the permanent split capacitor motors, otherwise known as PSC motors, are what we find in the older furnaces. In the newer furnaces of today, we have variable motors, or we have constant torque ECM, electronic commutative motors. The difference between these motors is that the newer variable ECM motors will actually ramp up when there's resistance in the system. They will try to target a certain speed. And with a shared return, if we were to put two furnaces back in, that return, they could start pulling against each other. The return air could actually suck against the blowers and maybe change the speed, and they would kind of get pulsing and doing some strange things. So when I came into this home, I thought, you know, we're going to have to find a way that we could do this with one furnace. And we did ultimately do that. What we have here today is our Daikin fully modulating furnace. That means it has about 65 stages of heating. And then we added the Daikin fit, which is an inverter compressor air conditioning unit working on an electronic expansion valve control board that can modulate the outdoor unit as well, giving us many stages of cooling and many stages of heating. And what's important about doing that is we don't have the ductwork to handle an entire load of the furnace at, let's say, a single stage or a two stage furnace would put way too much air in there. We'd have to use bypass dampers, which here again do not work. That's a whole nother subject about bleeding off air and just turning it right back in the furnace. So here at Grant's Heating, we don't do that. We don't use bypass dampers, and we definitely want to make sure that this equipment will work in this situation. So what we've done is added zoning. We added a zone damper here and one on the back side, brought them into our EWC controller, and we have a temperature sensor in here, which also gives us more information on how the system is operating. If it's getting too cold or too hot, we can actually change things within the computer system. So this, what we've done is taken the two furnaces and put one end with dampers on each side, which is how we're going to control the two levels with two Daikin 1 thermostats, which are Wi-Fi and fully communicating. You can use your app, it can sit on their couch and control the different levels of the home. And then we program this zone board, and in here there's some buttons. You can get in a little closer and take a look. It's actually given us some supply temperature readings, and it'll tell us what outdoor temperature is and a bunch of stuff. But we can program each one of these zone dampers to a certain amount of airflow. So we're going to do some duct calculations. We're going to check static pressures, which we did. And we know that this duct can handle so much of the zoning. So we tell this computer here that we only want to feed it, let's say, 40% of the overall system capacity. So that allows us to not over, you know, push too much air into that duct system. It makes sure that it doesn't get loud and noisy and all that velocity sounds and stuff you would get. So cool that we can control it, but that's why we want different stage equipment here. That's why we want to be able to throttle this back all the way down to a minimum of 35%, and same with the air conditioning unit, so that we can give just the right capacity for each zone. So we'll go over here a little bit and show you what we did on these. On this 5-ton furnace, we need to either pull from the side and the bottom, or both sides. And that's what we've done here. We've actually made a return drop as big as the 2025 filter. We're bringing all that air down, filtering it with a nice high efficiency filter. And then we brought the ductwork around the backside, and we were able to pull return from the right side of the furnace and pull return from the left side of the furnace by using this transfer piece of duct here to do that. And while you're back here, you can see the other zone damper that we're using. These are really nice. They have a light, indicates what they're doing. And this was the other furnace we had up here. So you can see that is that zone. But all that air gets filtered, pulled through, and brought into the furnace with optimal airflow and filtration. Now, these were their existing humidifiers. The customer decided they wanted to reuse these. So we actually connected them to one zone and to the other zone. And the customer found that one was enough for all of their needs. So they have shut one down. But it's pretty neat. We kind of reused their humidifiers that they had on their old system. They were still good shape. So I'm talking about the, we do install freeze and leak detectors. So this little wick you see on the floor, if any of that gets wet, that will shoot an alert to the customer that there's water on the floor. So that's definitely something that is a nice safety feature. We also will track humidity and temperature. And if the water heaters were to leak or something as well, that should pick that up. This is a overflow device that was installed. That will actually shut down the system if for some reason there's a problem with the drain on this coil during air conditioning use. But it was pretty neat to be able to take the two separate furnaces, bring it into one piece of equipment, and then be able to control how much we want to send down each one of those zones, giving full control to the customer and comfort levels. Okay, so we're outside here. I wanted to show you there was two traditional old air conditioning units here. As a matter of fact, you can see the disconnect for the other AC. There was an AC here, and there was an AC here for the two furnaces they had. So we were able to take this down to one air conditioner with many stages of cooling. And this is our Daikin Fit. So we've shown another video of our all-electric systems, and that was with a heat pump. They look very similar, but this one here is an AC unit only. But I wanted to show you how we were able to get rid of those old, big, traditional air conditioning units and go to this nice variable capacity AC that will work with zoning very well, because we can control the capacity and how much output we want for each zone. So yeah, I think that's really sharp looking.